Hey there, Pastor Kevin here for today's home huddle. As we move into one of the most familiar stories in the whole book of Daniel, even in the whole Bible itself, the story of Daniel in the lion's den. This story takes place in Daniel chapter 6, but let me give you a little bit of context before you jump there. Daniel, by this time, he's a pretty old guy. He's been around for a while in Babylon, and he's been an advisor in the kingdom since he was a teenager. When Daniel was in school in Babylon, he got high marks. He graduated with a great GPA from the Babylonian University and stepped right into a pretty important role in Babylon as one of the advisors. He was consistently reliable at his job, and his bosses gave him great performance reviews. So when the new king arrives in Babylon, King Darius, he's happy to have someone as reliable as Daniel on his staff. And pretty quick he realizes why Daniel has been praised so highly in the kingdom, because he is a distinguished worker. And so Darius gives Daniel even more responsibility in the kingdom. Well, this is all very cool for Daniel, but you might think of, well, Daniel's co-workers and how they would respond to this. As you might imagine, some of his co-workers weren't all that enthused with how well Daniel was exceeding in the kingdom, because they were trying to climb the corporate ladder themselves. And so they started plotting some way that they could take Daniel down, knock him a few rungs lower, so that they might climb up a little bit higher. So they get together, and in their jealousy of Daniel and his position, they come up with this plan to pass a law in the kingdom that's going to conflict with Daniel's devotion to his God, something they know is important to Daniel. They come up with this law, they slide it on the king's table, and they kind of pressure him quickly into passing it. Before King Darius even realizes what he's signing, it's in effect, and pretty soon Daniel is in a, well, you could say he's in a hairy situation. That's where the reading I have picked out for you today picks up for your home huddle today. Take courage from this story, from Daniel's life, as you watch what is the ultimate outcome for those who follow God. But also, what's the ultimate outcome for those who oppose God's will and God's followers? But also consider your life and how you might mimic the way Daniel responds in this chapter, and the way Daniel leads his life, how you might mimic that in your own life. Consider that as you share, read, talk, pray, and bless today.